Ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy Sabalin, your one-stop shop for K-pop and hip-hop, and I am kind of sick, but today, we are back. 4 days since my last upload, we are here today. Hey, did you guys see my new bag? It's a little hint for the video we got today because we got, bam, right here, New Jeans is back. New Jeans x Riot Games, two of my biggest passions in life right now, K-pop and League of Legends, are combining with their powers combined. They are giving us the 2023 League of Legends World Championships anthem. The title of the song is Gods, and I am super excited. Like I just said, League of Legends and K-pop are two of my biggest passions right now. Don't look at my match history, though. If you look at my match history, you'll see, you know, I'm getting some wins right here, guys. Right, you guys? I'm getting some wins. No, I'm not getting wins. I'm getting smashed every game. But anyways, New Jeans, 4th Gen Queens, top of K-pop right now internationally. You could argue, okay? I'm not trying to make an argument. I'm just saying that you could make an argument. And League of Legends, one of the most popular video games in the world today, if not the most popular video game in the world today. If you guys don't know, the World Championships is hosted in Korea this year. That's why they are doing this collaboration with K-pop. Initially, the people thought that it was going to be AT's because AT's was at Riot headquarters. But it's New Jeans, which to some people is even bigger than AT's. Okay, so I'm excited to get into this song. Don't mind my voice because it's mad weird because I'm sick. And let's get into this song. It's League of Legends. Isn't that crazy to just think about and say? It's New Jeans. It's the 2023 League of Legends World Championships anthem. It's Gods. It's Sabalin. It's like, comment, did you know that only 6% of y'all are subscribed to the YouTube channel? Before we get into this song, before we get our God mode on, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, hit that bell so you get notifications whenever I post. Because it helps the channel grow and gives me the motivation to keep pumping out videos for y'all. So, let's stop wasting y'all time, and without further ado, it is League of Legends, it is New Jeans, it's Gods. Let's go. Okay. Gods featuring New Jeans. This is so crazy to me. Oh man, let's go. I wonder what it's gonna sound like. Okay, this is pretty epic so far. How is New Jeans fit into this equation? Oh, is that Faker? Is that Deft? Okay, guys, I don't know what to do. Do I want to give it the K-pop approach, or do I want to take it from the League of Legends fan approach? Because the video is about League of Legends, but the song is about New Jeans, so I don't know. I don't know what angle you guys want me to tackle it from. I can do both at the same time. Ah, screw it. Let's just go. Is it hidden? Oh my god! Did you hear that ad lib? Yo! Okay, we gotta start from the top. Let's start from the top. Let's tap in. This is what you came for. Blood on the game bow. Everybody drop it like rainfall. This is your moment. Eyes on a bumper. Can't think church just open. The Church of Chovy! It's Baron Nashor! Oh my god, I'm messing with this. Once you play God, once you play God, they're gonna crumble one by one. Then we gonna ride right into the sun. Oh yeah, we play League of Legends, baby. Oh, they went high up there. Oh, what up, Def? Oh my gosh, it's... he got denied. That Haim? Ooh, I like that. Breathe. Mad girl woke up, chose violence. Hold up. Who sang that line? Lock in, Deft. Why? Woo! Is that Uzi? Oh, Deft got crumbled. Is that Showmaker? Oh, who's that? Dude. Oh, it's Karia! Oh, okay. I'm a nerd on my League of Legends tip right now, but Karia used to be the support for Deft, who's the main character in his music video. He used to be on the same team as Deft, and he sacrificed him for the good of the team. Oh my goodness. Is this just like a Deft career retrospective in a music video? It's so hard to focus on the song and League of Legends at the same time, the storyline of the video. Is that supposed to be Showmaker? Because I think that's Damwon's uniform. I know I'm splitting the audience in half right now between the K-pop fans and the League fans. But just, hey, bear with me, bro. This is so sick. Once you play God, they're gonna crumble one by one. Oh my God, Deft is getting clapped. My God, new jeans can do epic. They can do stadium songs. What is that? Oh no, he's in the upside down. His dreams of winning worlds have shattered. I'm on my knees. Me too. Anyone with this underdog song. Oh, look at DRX. Lifting him up out of the shadows! Oh, it's Scout! Oh, it's Mako! Whoops! Can I just say, I am so excited for Worlds this year. You guys don't freaking understand. Any League fans out there, I am so excited for the World Championships this year. This song is already getting me excited. Hey, Lil Nas X, I'm sorry. Your world's anthem got bodied by New Jeans. Slide over, bro. Woo-hoo-wee. So the storyline, man got clapped by Showmaker. DRX pulls him out of the upside down. I can't lose, man. DRX is raising his heart. Who's that? That's Renekton. Is that Doron? Oh, we're beating everybody. It's Karia. Oh my God. It's Faker. Oh, yo, this video is crazy. Death, don't let Faker kill you. Is it Barrel? Oh, it's DRX, baby! It's an Ace to Aatrox that T1 didn't ban for some reason. And he did it! Deft won his first world championship. Been playing League for 10 years and he finally did it. Once you play! Yo, I am so excited. I am so excited. Who is this? Is that JDG Ruler? Oh, it's just a bunch of all the other nobodies. All the other nobodies. Because the video is about Deft. And then they have to throw in all the everybody else. I'm just kidding. They're not nobodies. There's Ruler. I don't know who IU is. Is he from Wildcard Region? Then we got Jose Diodo. Isn't he from NA? Jose Diodo is trash. Is that Blabber? Yeah, that was Blabber, I think. Then we got Chovy. I think that's Yagao. Is that Yagao? No, that's not Yagao. I don't know, bro. Yutapon, Levi, Azzy. Yutapon from DFM, I think. Levi from Gigabyte Marines. Oh, no, I think he's on PSG now. Anyways, I know I took that whole music video into 20 different directions, but what do you want? Let me just put this video on loop. What do you want? What are the things that you want from a League of Legends anthem? Okay, because we've gotten the League of Legends anthems we've gotten in the past. You know, Legends Never Die, Warriors, songs like that. What do you want? You want songs that are epic. You want songs that are getting you hyped. When you think about Worlds Finals, when I think about previous Worlds, the song immediately pops in my head, because when I think of Legends Never Die, that takes me back to a whole nother time of my life. When I was watching Worlds on Twitch, getting ads, 60 seconds, are you kidding me, Twitch? And waiting for the next SKT game back in the day. And I think New Jeans really did it with this one. Now, this could just be me, but their voices really blended really kind of blended into another a lot in this track, which could, it's either I just can't tune into their voices on this track, or that is a result of the mixing. But I did recognize Heron in the beginning, and I think I recognized Danielle in the pre-chorus to the verse. But as far as, I think Hain as well, I remember, but Minji and Hani, I didn't recognize. So if you guys can tell me, I'll probably just watch a line distribution to figure that out myself. But yeah, the song is epic. We Zona Play, God. This song is, listen. This is the first listen, so I didn't really catch. Who is that, Reckless? What did Reckless do to Deft? Anyways, let me start this from the top. So, as far as the song goes, this is it satisfies me for a world's anthem. Upon deeper analysis, will it stack up to Legend Never Die, which I think is one of my favorite world anthem of all time? That remains to be seen. Legend Never Die is a timeless song. And I'm not comparing it to Nuji's other work. I'm not comparing this world song to other Nugene songs. I'm comparing it to other world's anthems. And as far as world's anthems goes, I'll tell you this, it's better than Star Walking. Sorry, Lil Nas X. I don't know what Riot Games was thinking, getting Lil Nas X to do the world's anthem, but I think they kind of missed with that. It's a good song, but it's not a world song. And this is more along the lines of what we want a world song to be, epic. Grand, you know, you want to hear this in a big stage, on a giant stadium, because I think the venue for the world's finals is like a giant 50,000 seater, so that's perfect. As far as the storyline of the video goes, it really is just storyline about Deft. If you guys don't know, Deft was the guy who won world championships last year with his team DRX. It was such a amazing Cinderella story. Think about this. Okay, I'm not going to give him the whole life story, but just pretend. Man's been playing League for as long as Faker has. And if you guys know Faker, Faker is the undisputed GOAT of League of Legends, okay? 3 world championships in contention for multiple more. And Deft has always been second fiddle. He's always made it to the dance. He's always been second fiddle to the other main players. He's been behind Faker. He's been behind the Chinese teams. He's been behind other Korean teams. But 2022, he comes to Worlds with DRX. DRX barely even qualified for Worlds. Had to make it through the World, the play-ins. They barely qualify for Worlds. They go in this amazing Cinderella run. They beat the best teams in the world. They beat Gen G. They beat, I think, JDG. They beat T1 in game five of an amazing series. Why didn't T1 ban Aatrox? The world will never know. But the Deft story was told brilliantly here. That last scene where DRX pulls him out of the shadows, where he got clapped by Showmaker. They pull him out of the shadows. They run through Gen G. They run through EDG. It was EDG. And in the finals, he meets his support from years and years ago. I think Carrier was on DRX in around 2018, 2017. And he left DRX to go to T1. And in the finals, four or five years after he leaves, he meets him again in the World Championship Finals, and he gets his revenge on his longtime support. Almost puts the bullet in his head, and then Faker has to save the day to extend it a little bit, but Deft gets his victory in the end. I love the storyline of this video. As you can tell, I'm a League of Legends nerd. I love League of Legends, and the storyline of this video is excellent. So, I guess I did tackle it from two point of views. I tackled it from the K-pop point of view, and I thought the song was great. It's perfect for a league anthem. It's grand. It's very, not orchestral. Like I said, grand, stadium status, Kanye West type-ish. And as far as the League of Legends side, the music video is perfect. It tells the storyline of Deft really well. They stylize it. They animate it a little bit. You see Deft is crying because he finally got what he was chasing for. You know, he got his Moby Dick. And we're getting ready for Worlds 2023, bro! Worlds 2023! And I'm excited. Look at that. And they stuck Ruler at the end of this video, knowing that Ruler's probably gonna win Worlds this year, but and his team, because JDG looks like the best team in the world. But, you know, the storyline's about Deft, so we'll leave it at that. Anyways, let's wrap it up here. Song is great. It's going on the playlist. I'm gonna be bumping it. I'm gonna learn more about the track. And as far as the storyline of the video, you guys already got that. So let's wrap this long ass video up. But that's just what I think. Let me know what y'all think down in the comments below. Did you love this track? Did you hate it? Why? Shout out to Anthony Fantano. Do you even like League of Legends, or do you just like Nugene's? Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Will this track make you watch a single game of League of Legends World Championships this year? Let me know. because I am definitely going to be watching a bunch of the games. As far as the timing goes, the timing is trash because it is in Korea. So the earliest the game starts is 3 a.m. But good thing for me, my sleep schedule is absolute doggy doo-doo. So I'll be up for a lot of those games. And yeah, shout out to New Jeans. They knocked it out of the park with this World's Anthem. It's better than Star Walking. And will it, as far as my GOAT World songs, Warriors and Legends Never Die, I'm going to have to give it more listens to be able to give you a final opinion on that. And you already got my thoughts about the blending of the voices as well. So yeah, that was Gods. That was New Jeans. That was Riot Games. That was League of Legends. That was the World's 2023 Anthem. That was Sabalin. That was Like, Comment, and Did You Know that only 6% of y'all are subscribed to the YouTube channel? Before y'all got on League of Legends and lose 23 games in a row and lose all your LP and go back to copper. Sorry, go back to iron. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that bell to get notifications whenever I post, because it helps the channel grow and gives me the motivation to keep popping out videos for y'all. And I know I lost all y'all K-pop heads when I started going into the League nerd stuff, but I'll see y'all in the next motherfucking video, which should be a Vicha reaction. And I'll see y'all motherfuckers in the next one. Peace.